So the next topic to be discussed is cursors in PLSQL. First I will discuss what is a cursor, and then I will go for types of cursors like implicit cursor and explicit cursor. First let me discuss what is meant by cursor. So whenever a SQL statement is executed in Oracle, like any SQL statement, so Oracle is going to create one piece of memory. Okay, so that piece of memory is used by the rows to be processed. Okay, so once again I will explain. Whenever a SQL statement is executed, automatically a piece of memory will be created by the Oracle. Okay, why for that piece of memory? The rows to be processed. Okay, so after creation of that working after creation of that piece of memory, and that is also called as work area. After creating of that, what happens here? Into that area, the rows to be processed or fetched. The rows to be processed or stored. So once after execution of that, PL SQL statement, what happens automatically? The area which is allocated, the piece of memory which is allocated by Oracle, automatically that is deallocated, that is realized. Okay. So that kind of piece of memory in our Oracle PLSQL terminology is called as what? Cursor. A cursor is nothing but work area or a piece of memory which is created by Oracle for the rows to be processed. And whenever the rows processing is completed, automatically the piece of memory, the work area will be deallocated, released. So automatically creation of work area, rows switching into work area, discarding of work area, automatically these tasks are performed by Oracle. Okay. So it is not our in the hands of developer. Automatically that those duties are performed by Oracle. So automatically they are done. So because of that reason, that is called as what? Implicit cursor or implicit work area or cursor, simply we can say. Okay, a cursor is nothing but it is a piece of memory created by Oracle whenever an SQL statement is executed. And whenever the SQL statement is executed, Oracle is going to create one piece of memory and rows will be fetching. And after rows processing, what happens automatically? The area is discarded by the Oracle. So completely the operation is performed by Oracle. So because of that reason, so that is called as implicit work area or implicit cursor. Okay. So when we discuss types of cursors, we are going to have two types. One is implicit. So this category, implicit cursor means, so this will be coming under this category. And second kind of cursor is what? Explicit cursor. Explicit cursor. So what is the explicit cursor? Explicit means it is non-automated. So it is not created by Oracle. It will be created by developers, users. Why you have to create cursors? What is the use? What is the requirement? What is the need? So those things I will explain. Suppose here we have a table called product. Suppose we have a table called product. And I have some information like product ID and product name, quantity, unit price, and finally I have total. Now product ID is there, name is there, quantity is there, unit price is there. Now based on quantity and unit price, I want to calculate total. Suppose this table contains some 1000 rows. Okay, so in case of 1000 rows, each and every row must be processed clearly. Each and every row has to be scanned. Okay, so after scanning of each and every row, we have to process quantity and we have to calculate total. Okay, for this I have to make use of one non-automatic cursor called as explicit cursor. Okay, using explicit cursor, I am going to process individual rows one by one. I am going to scan each and every row. You take some other example like we have one table called employee. So in employee table, I have some information like ID of the employee, name of the employee, job of the employee, salary, bonus, and total salary. Total salary. This table contains ID, name, job, salary, bonus and total salary. Now, just you have a look, many job groups are there, like manager is there, clerk is there, scientist, developer, and tester, admin, like this have many groups. Depending upon job category, I want to give bonus. That means the table, employee table must be scanned. Okay, just imagine employee table also contains some 10,000 or 1,000, any number of, any amount of rows it may contain based on job category. If the job is manager, I wanted to give bonus like 5,000. Oh, this is for managers. For scientists, I want to give something like same 5,000. For developers, I want to give 3,000. For tester, I want to give same 3,000. For admins, I want to give 4,000. And for any other job group, I wanted to give 2,000. That means each and every row must be processed here. Each and every row must be scanned. Okay. So on verification of job, I will decide bonus. Okay. Upon calculation of bonus, after that finally I will calculate our total salary. So in this scenario, so I have to check each and every row of employee table. So to check each and every row, to scan each and every row, so we have to use cursors. That means cursor is explicit cursor is a work area where we are going to store all the rows of a table to be processed. That means from that row, from that cursor, we are going to fetch the information. So you can also define a explicit cursor. Just like a explicit cursor is just like a virtual table, okay, where all the rows to be processed in the table are stored. So as long as the application is living, as long as the application is existed, the explicit cursor is there. So whenever the application is closed, what happens here? Explicit cursor will be closed. That is just like a virtual table. That means actual information is there in the virtual table, base table. From virtual table, we are going to fetch information into cursor, virtual table. Now using some concepts, using some mechanism, we are going to scan. So what kind of mechanism? Cursor, we can check the information. Okay, so once the job is scanned, depending on job group, I want to calculate bonus, and upon calculation of bonus, finally I can calculate what? Total salary. That means the main intention of explicit cursor is to scan and to update each and every row of a table. Okay, especially for scanning, especially for updation of each and every row of a table, we can make use of explicit cursor. So this is a explicit cursor concept. So for handling explicit cursor, we are going to take follow some steps. So what are the steps to be followed? I will discuss now. Just may put a heading like steps for using explicit cursors or cursors, simply you can say cursors. In the industry, they will be saying cursors, not explicit cursors, because implicit cursor is not going to be used by us. Explicit cursor. So what are the steps to be followed while using explicit cursor? Means the first step of explicit cursor is, so this is just like declaration of cursor. So how we are going to declare rows, how we are going to declare a cursor? So to declare a cursor, so we have to use a keyword called cursor name is query. Here you can write like this. Suppose cursor name is, suppose C is select ID, comma, name, comma, job from employee. So in this example, what happens here? from employee table, it is going to fetch ID, name, job. ID, name, job will be fetching. So another example I will give. Cursor C1, this is C1, this is C2, suppose, is select star from employee. What is the difference here? Difference between first example and second example is what? So in the first example, only ID, name, job will be retrieved. So in the second example, what I said here, star indicates what? All the columns of employee table. Okay, third example I will give. Cursor C3 is select star from employee, select star from employee for update of what? Bonus, comma, total salary. What is this? What is the meaning of third one? So in the first case, what happens means ID, name, job will be selected. So from using the ID, name, job can be displayed directly. And in case of second example, so what is the second example here? Second example is cursor C2 is select star from employee. Now this is going to fetch all the rows. So this is for displaying what values, that's all. If you want to display the rows, just you can use this mechanism. And if you want to update rows in employee table, so you have to use this option. Select cursor C3 is select star from employee for update of bonus, comma, total salary. That means in this example, clearly you are telling that we require a cursor for updation of bonus and total salary. So in the above case, the cursor is open for read only. So in the second case, what happens here? The cursor is open for updation of bonus and total salary. So that what happens here? What is the difference here? The exclusive lock is applied. For when you say for update of bonus total salary, so on these columns, exclusive lock is applied by the Oracle. Just for the sake of creating one cursor called C3. So what is the sake here? Bonus and total salary. So this is especially for updation of bonus and total salary, you can open C3 cursor. Now these are the three versions. First version is going to fetch only ID, name, job from employee. Second version is cursor C2 is select star from employee. So here we cannot update any rows. So in the third case, what is happening here? Clearly you are specifying that update of bonus, comma, total salary. By this, what happens here? A exclusive lock is applied especially for you. Okay. So till your transactions are finished, the lock is there. So whenever you finish the transaction, the lock is released by the Oracle. So that is especially the purpose of for update of clause, for update of bonus and total salary. Okay. Now this becomes the first step. So in the second step, what we are going to do means opening a cursor. Open cursor. So this statement is going to fetch rows from employee table to cursor. What is our cursor name? Cursor name is C1. Into C1, what happens? Rows will be fetching from table to cursor. Suppose here I have some information like your employee table is there. Just you have a look. Employee. So in employee, we have these columns like ID, name, job, salary, uh,
Bonus. Bonus. Total salary. Like this. Just imagine some rows. 701. 702. Something like Ram. Rakesh. Job is something like clerk. The developer. Salaries 10,000. Developer salaries some 20,000. Bonus we don't calculate. 703. Again, this is suppose Raj is tester. Tester, his salary is something like 15,000. Bonus, total salary. So this is original table. This is a original table. So from this, what happens here? A area is created like this. This is C1. So into C1, what happens? When I say open C1, from this, the rows are fetching into C1. ID, name, job, salary, bonus, bonus, total salary. So like 701, 702, 703. C is Ram, Rakesh, Raj. Jobs, clerk, developer, and tester. Salary is 10,000. Now 20,000. Now 15,000. Like this. Now this becomes what? C1. By open statement, what happens here? Temporarily, rows are fetched from employee table to C1 cursor. And C1 becomes pointer. C1 becomes pointer. And the pointer is going to point to first row of the table. C 701, RAM, C, and 10,000. Okay? The main intention, by opening a cursor, what happens? Actual information will be brought from base table to cursor. Base table to cursor. By this open statement. And next statement, this is fetch rows one by one. So to fetch rows from cursor, just you have to use fetch cursor into variable 1, variable 2, like that. Suppose fetch something like C1 into, I may use EMPREC. What is EMPREC? It is a percentage row type variable which can contain all the columns of employee table. This is regarding fetch rows one by one. So how to fetch the rows? Fetch cursor into variable 1. Example, fetch C1 into EMPREC. EMPREC is a percentage row type variable. Already we have discussed in the PLSQL introduction part. Percentage type and percentage row type. Okay. And that means the first row of C1, the first row of C1 will be fetching into EMPREC. Okay. So the first statement always that must be written in the loop. One loop, that can be any loop, basic loop or for loop or while loop, whatever loop it may be. Okay. So the first statement must be written within the loop only. So after fetching the record, the current record, the current row is available in EMPREC percentage row type variable. Using that EMPREC, we can process the rows. So how we can process? Like processing means calculation of bonus and total salary. So that we can perform by third step. So next last step is, once the fetching is over, what you have to do finally? Close the cursor. Close cursor. So how to close the cursor? Just syntax is close Cursor name. Cursor name. For example, close C1. Close C1. By this, what happens here? The cursor is closed. And finally, the area allocated for program processing will be discarded. So these are the steps to be followed while using explicit cursor. In the declaration for declaration of cursor, just we are going to specify one name for the set of rows of employee table. So in the second step, what is going to be happened here? Open cursor. So when you open cursor, what happens from the base table? The rows will be fetched, the rows will be retrieved into cursor. And by third step, what happens? The first row of cursor will be fetching into what? Variable. Fetch cursor into variable name, fetch C1 into EMPREC. So finally, after completion of all rows processing, what do we have to do? We have to close the cursor. So to close a cursor, just we have to use close cursor name, close C1. So these are the mandatory steps when you want to use explicit cursors. Okay. Just I will discuss one small program and explicit cursors. Just you have a look. Set server output on, say, declare. Then declare the declaration statement. First I will declare a cursor. Cursor C1 is select star from product, put a semicolon at the end, and for this you declare a variable. What is the variable? Prod or is prod record, prod record. So it must be same as prod table record, prod dot prod, prod percentage, percentage row type, prod percentage row type. And within this begin block, just you open the cursor, open C1 and start a loop. I am using basic loop for first time. Next I will discuss for loop, cursors with for loops. Now use DBMS underscore output dot put underscore line display the values. So what are the values to be displayed? Suppose here we have one table prod. I will take ID, name, cost of the item, quantity and total price. Here are some items like P001, name is something like computer, cost is 20,000. P002, something like laptop, this is 30,000. Quantity 2, here quantity 3. Next item is P003, this is mobile, this is 15,000. And P004, I may give some other products like furniture, the worth of 50,000, it is 4, it is 5. Like this, I have one table. Now, when I say prod REC, what happens here? Prod REC, prod percentage row type. So the entire columns, ID, name, cost, quantity, total price. Okay, so can be obtained by using prod REC variable. Can be obtained prod REC variable. So for that I am doing what? Cursor C1 is select start from product. So this is prod. Prod.
And using DBMS output dot put line, I want to print first ID and name. ID name. Okay, ID name I want to print. So to print ID and name, just I have to make use of what? Okay. Before that, I have to fetch the cursor, no? So just you fetch the cursor. Fetch. So what is the cursor name I have declared here? Cursor name is C1. Fetch C1 into what? Prod REC means the current row of C1 will be fetching into prod REC. Already prod REC we have declared, and in the next immediate line we have to check whether rows are available in the prod table or not. So when the rows are not available, what must be done? The program must be halted. The program must be terminated. Okay. So yeah, exit C1 percentage not found. I will explain what is not found after this program. Exit C1 percentage not found. What is the meaning here? Whenever no rows are found on C1, automatically the program execution will be halted, because after completion of every row we cannot process the row. So exit when C1 percentage not found. This is mandatory condition. Okay. Meaning of this line is whenever the fetch statement fails to fetch the rows, the process will be terminated. The fetching process will be terminated. Otherwise, what action I have to take? I have to print all the values. Just I will print all the values. You can perform anything. First, as the first program, just I will print how to print values from product table using cursors by using basic loops. DBMS output dot put underscore line. Okay. What can I do here? Using prod REC, I can obtain ID, name, cost. Just I will print prod ID. So using that, the rows are available in prod REC. Prod REC dot what ID? ID concatenation, and give a space between two columns, and once again concatenation, and say prod REC dot name. And say end loop. Finally, close the cursor. Close C1. Finally, you say end. Okay. Declaration. Opening a cursor. Fetching row by row into prod REC. Exits when C1 percentage. So whenever no rows are found, automatically the fetching process will be failed. And otherwise, I am printing the output. Prod REC dot ID. Prod REC dot name. Okay. How many times this loop is repeated? This fetch statement will be repeated for 4 times, because we have 4 rows in product table. Okay. Fetch statement is repeated. Open statement is executed for only 1 time. Declaration statement, cursor declaration statement is done only 1 time. Close C1 is executed for only 1 time. Only fetch statement will be repeated for more than 1 time. That depending upon number of rows in my product table. Okay, so this is only printing ID and name. Like this, you can have printing all these columns like ID, name, cost, quantity, and total price. I will show it practically.